Yo lads, how's it going? And welcome back to another guide. Today the UCL promo just ended up getting released and I'm a bit mixed emotions about the event. Considering how good Team of the Season was, this is a little bit of a drop off, but that tends to happen with FIFA anyway. But today I'm going to walk through what is free to play from the event and how you can get the Prime Icon Zidane for just $25. Steal of a deal. I'm getting quite good at these poems. If you are new to the channel, I would appreciate a brand new subscription. If you are new to the channel, I'd appreciate a sub. Again, the YouTube subscribers are rising at a rapid amount. I do appreciate all the support, especially on these guide videos. They are genuinely doing insane. If a video does end up helping you out, please do consider leaving a like. Please do consider leaving a like button. If these guide videos do end up helping you out, then please do consider leaving a like. It does help out the channel a lot. Got it. Again, shameless self promo, but I do have a Twitch channel. The link is on screen if you want to go and follow me on there, or there's a link in the description to all my other social medias, just so you can keep up to date when we're going to be posting on YouTube, Twitch, etc, etc. But now, into the guide. So, as always, we have a normal promo and the UCL pass, but I'm just going to walk you through the basic event flow to kickstart. So, on the main chapter, you have 5 skill games a day that you need to end up playing. On day 1, it's going to be easy. On day 2, after you hit 15 stars, it's going to be medium. And then on day 3 to 13, it's going to be the harder skill games. But these come through in base stamina. No event stamina, so which means you can replay these as many times as you want just to end up trying to get the 3 stars. And then when you do, you end up claiming all 3 of the daily star milestones. They are cumulative, so every day you can claim all 3 of these milestones pretty easily. After you complete the 5 skill games, you get a UCL ticket, which you can use to play the bonus match. That gives UCL score to help you go through the pass. And then the rewards is where you spend all your points that you get from completing the skill games and the daily star milestones. So the points go into the rewards where you can claim the players, and then the daily match gives you levels in the UCL pass, which also gives you a few more points and a couple of extra rewards. Just note at the end, there is also a player that's free to play and then the pay to play pass as well. The UCL player box is where you get all your tokens from, one, your daily login, or the weekly matchups. I haven't started these just yet, but basically you have 15 games a week. 15 games max, so that includes the refilled energy, and then it also includes the ads and the coin offers. You don't need the coin offers, so I stay away from them at all costs. But do not claim this current reward until you've played all 15 games. Don't claim it straight away. You can only claim it once a week. The end of an era, you're just going to win 10 bonus matches. That includes the weekly refresh. So you have to just win 10 games out of the 2 weeks of weekly matchups. When claiming one of the end of era players, you can only choose one of them. If you want to get both of them, then you need to spend 5,000 gems. Just a quick note, there is some missing players. This 104 Kante is one of them. He comes available in some chain packs next week. And I presume the Laporte is with him. I don't think the Laporte is in the event. I might be wrong. But the Kante is definitely in the chain packs. A really well-rounded center mid. And I'm happy to announce that I will be giving him away on tomorrow's stream. So again, if you're not already following on Twitch, make sure you're following on there. Again, a link on screen right now and also a link in the description. And then the milestones, spend 15,000 UCL points to get Gerrard and 25k to get Zidane. Now, what is free to play? Okay, so I'm going to start popping up some of the event maps that come on screen. But basically, from daily logins, you get 50 UCL tokens and 65 UCL points. Again, the tokens go in the UCL player box and the UCL points go into the reward path. You have 5 skill games a day, each give 40 for when completing. So 5 times 40 is 200. There's 13 days of the event, so 200 times 13 days is 2,600 UCL points. Now, when you complete all 5 skill games and you get 3 stars on each, you'll be able to claim all 3 of these daily star milestones. So I've got 3 stars and 4 on the skill games. Once I claim this milestone, the second milestone will end up unlocking as well. So 175 points there. And then I also can claim the 200 on the 10 stars. Once I complete this 5th skill game, I'll be able to complete the last node as well. 3 stars complete, which means I can claim this 3rd daily star milestone. And then it means I also unlock the ticket as well, which I'll end up using to complete the hard game. The hard match should be fairly easy. If you end up losing these games, then you get your ticket back, so you can just play it as many times as you want. You might as well attempt the hard game. If you are free to play or you've just joined the game, then you can go to the easy one if you need to. You don't have to do the hard match. It just helps you complete the UCL pass quicker, that's all. So if we go to the guide, the easy star milestone path gives 15 stars on day 1. Once you've completed 15 stars, you go to the medium on day 2. And then once you've completed 15 stars on medium, you go to day 3 on the hard. For day 1, you get 175, 200 plus 250. Day 2, you get 250 plus 275 plus 300. And then from day 3 to 13, 275 plus 300 plus 350. So in terms of UCL points, that gives you a total of 11,625 UCL points. And then in terms of the hard matches, you can get easily 2,600 UCL score. The max amount of UCL points free to play is 2,600 from the skill games, 11,625 from the UCL points and the star milestones. And then you get 65 for logging in over 13 days, which gives a total of 15,070 UCL points, which means Gerard is free to play. Don't worry if you end up don't getting 15 stars on one day, you do get an extra 1,500 UCL points in the pass for free. Node 1 gives 500 and then Node 7 gives another 1,000. And you can also get more score by just watching the ads if you want to go through the pass a little bit quicker. Which means Node 7 should be possible within 3 days of the event. Now, how can you get Zidane for just $25? I'm just going to put this out there. There is a chance that this Zidane might end up changing. The fact that you only need 25,000 points is a little bit sketchy. So as we said earlier, 15,070 just from doing the skill games. And then the free-to-play pass gives another 1,500. Which means 16,570 points is free to play. Now, the bulk of this comes from the UCL pass. You get an extra 2,500 there, an extra 3,500 at node 7, which is another 6,000 UCL points. That puts you at 22,570 UCL points. Then if you go to the store, if you go to the Bellingham offer at UCL Starter 1, you buy this one for another £2. I don't know how much it converts to dollars, but for pounds, it's about £22 in total with the UCL pass. That gives another 100 to make 22,670. Then you get offer 2 and offer 3 with your free-to-play gems. If you don't have any gems, then it is going to cost you another 3,000 FIFA points, which is about another 30 great British pounds. But node 2 gives 750 and node 3 gives 2,000, which gives you 25,420 points from just the UCL starters and the pass. Very easy. Now, what can you end up getting with the 16,500 points? Just going to put it on screen. This is from Frangen. But basically, you can end up claiming anything below the 101 Mahrez. If you end up getting the pass, then you can get the 102 Mbappe or De Bruyne. It's your choice. But if you end up going for Zidane as well, then you just need to claim the Neymar. And you must be getting 15 stars every single day for that. If we just jump to the guide quickly for the VSA or head-to-head section, you don't need to buy the coin packs because you get the energy over the course of the week anyway. If you just want to complete the games a bit quicker, then you can buy the coin packs, but you can sell yourself a few coins that way. All you need to aim for is the 8 wins out of the 15 matches that you have available to get 900 UCL tokens. So there's obviously 2 weeks of this event, which means you can get another 1,800 through the weekly matches to spend on the roulette wheel. So if you end up getting the 8 wins, you get 900 over 2 weeks, which is 1,800. But then remember, you get 50 from the daily claim. So over 13 days, that gives you a total of 2,450 UCL tokens. And then you also get another 300 for free in the UCL pass. So a grand total of 27 spins on the roulette wheel. So if your lucky is in, you might end up getting the Hazard. But it means Up to the Rare Shards is free to play. I don't think this path resets for week 2 of the event. Appreciate everyone watching. Just keep note that the price of Zidane might end up changing. So I maybe wait until the end of the event just to see if Zidane's price does change before spending any of your money. Don't want EA scamming you. But I appreciate everyone watching the video. If it did help you out, please do leave a like and subscribe if you are new. Does help out the channel a lot. Make sure you're following over on Twitch. You might enjoy some of my more content over on some streams. It's completely free to watch over there as well. But thank you all so much for watching. I hope you have a great weekend and a great rest of your day. And until the next video, I'll catch you a little bit later. Stay sick, stay epic, and peace out. Adios.